If you shot any weddings or live events with a DSLR or older mirrorless camera body, then you probably run into the issue of camera record time limits. Now, this dates back to 1997 when the World Trade Organization put a limit of 30 minutes for any video recording on digital cameras. But that ran out in 2019, so most of the camera bodies like the R6 Mark II that I'm using right now no longer have that video record limit. But what happens when you want to use an older camera body like this EOS R for your B or C cam that you're not going to be manning? Well, the solution I use to work around this video record limit is using a wired intervalometer. I'll put a link to this particular one in the description below. It's for Canon bodies, and it comes with ends to use for both the mirrorless camera bodies and the older DSLR style ports. So the way you use this intervalometer for video recording is you set it to just longer than your video record limit so that when the camera hits the limit, it will stop recording. Then the intervalometer will start the recording back a few seconds later. You do need to keep in mind that your camera may have to buffer for a few seconds before it starts back. So you'll need to run several tests prior to actually doing this on that wedding or live event. You are going to need to change one setting on your camera. You need to go into menu, scroll over the wrench icon, go down to shutter button function, scroll down to fully press, and change that from no function to start stop movie record. That allows the intervalometer to trigger the shutter button to start and stop video recording. Now on the intervalometer, you want the delay to be set at 0 seconds. Also under long, you want that to be set on 0 seconds. That's how long it will hold the shutter button down. For the interval, you want to set that at just over the video record time on your camera. So for mine, I have it set at 29 minutes, 54 seconds. I found that the time on the camera's clock versus the time on my intervalometer's clock doesn't quite match up. This allows a buffer of several seconds for when the camera hits the record limit to when the intervalometer starts recording back. On N, this is the number of times it's going to run this cycle, including the initial cycle that you run. So 4 that I have it set to now, that's going to be a total of 4 cycles of 30 minutes or about 2 hours of recording. Finally, I want to turn off the music icon. I don't want it to be beeping during a wedding. So to start the video recording, you're going to have the camera turned on with the intervalometer plugged in, set up, ready to go on the video settings that you want. Then you're going to press any button to wake up the intervalometer and push the timer start stop button once. You'll see the camera start recording and you'll see timer active on the intervalometer. Then you'll see the timer start to count down. Once the camera reaches its 30 minute time limit, the camera will stop recording. Then the intervalometer will start the recording back a few seconds later. Just as a way of cord management, I've also put some Velcro on the back of my intervalometer and some Velcro on my tripod, so that keeps things nice and neat when I'm at a wedding ceremony. While this workaround isn't nearly as good as the camera's firmware allowing you unlimited record time, it's still a great workaround that allows you to have completely unmanned cameras that can continue to record for as long as the battery lasts. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell to be alerted of any future videos.